Hello friends, welcome back to Pritha's Cooking House. I am Pritha and today I will be sharing with you a very famous Bengali traditional recipe which is called Echore Chop or Raw Jackfruit Cutlet. So this is a very traditional and very famous. If you are Bengali, then you must know about this recipe. And if you are non-Bengali, then also you must try this recipe at your home. And I must tell you, this is a pure veg recipe. I mean, this is a Jain veg recipe. That means there is no garlic and no onion. So let's see what are the ingredients we will be requiring for making raw jackfruit cutlet or echore chop. Before that, I must remind you that if you are new here, then don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. And if you like the recipe, then don't forget to like the video and share the video with your family and friends. And also comment on the below comment section. Let's see what are the ingredients we will be requiring. I have taken here 4 boiled potatoes, 200 grams raw jackfruit, fresh coriander leaves, roughly crushed peanuts, salt as per taste, 1 tablespoon ginger paste, 1 teaspoon Maggi masala, 1 teaspoon roasted masalas, which is also called bhaja masala, 2 tablespoon all-purpose flour, around 100 grams breadcrumbs and 1 cup refined oil. Now at first we need to mash the potatoes very well. Then we will be adding the boiled raw jackfruits. Now roughly mash the raw jackfruits along with the potatoes. Now after roughly mashing these, we need to add the ginger paste, salt as per taste, Maggi masala and roasted masalas into it. And Maggi masala you can get from any grocery stores. This is optional. And roasted masala recipe I have shared before also. This is basically I have taken some cumin seeds, some coriander seeds and some dry red chilies. And then I have roasted it in a pan for 3 minutes, then I have grinded it. So this is basically called bhaja masala in Bengali, or you can call it as roasted masala. This is also optional. And we will be adding some crushed peanuts and some coriander leaves. Now need to mix all the ingredients properly. After mixing all the ingredients properly, the mixture is now ready. Now we need to take a small portion from this mixture and need to give it a good shape. I am giving it an oval shape, but you can give any other shape as per your choice. See, all the shaping of the cutlets are done. Now I have taken here one mixture or a batter which is made with all-purpose flour or maida and water and some breadcrumbs. Now we need to do the coating of the cutlets. For coating of the cutlets, we need to take one cutlet and need to put it into the maida mixture or all-purpose flour mixture and then need to coat it with the breadcrumbs. We need to ensure that all the sides of these cutlets needs to be properly coated with these breadcrumbs, because the crispiness of the cutlets depends on this breadcrumb coating. Now, following the same procedure, all the cutlets needs to be coated well. See, all the cutlets are well coated. Now you need to give it a rest time for minimum 20 minutes and you need to refrigerate it. And if you want, you can store it for 7 to 10 days in refrigerator, and whenever you want to eat, you can take it out and can fry this. Now after 20 minutes of rest time, we need to fry this, and for frying I have taken one frying pan and some refined oil into it, and when the oil is well heated, I am frying these cutlets. All the sides needs to be fried well. Now the color has been changed and it looks like the cutlets are perfectly fried. Now we need to take it out from the oil. Now following the same procedure, I have fried all the cutlets and it looks perfect and yummy and very delicious. So how was the recipe? I hope you all liked it, and if you liked, then don't forget to subscribe my channel if not done yet and press the bell icon. And if you like the recipe, then please share the video with your family and friends. We'll be back very soon with a new recipe. Till then, bye bye, take care.